Hello, my name is Anne, and welcome to the very last Toby Knits Quilty Fun Special Cotton Cuts Spring Mini Mystery Kit. Today, we're putting it together. Oh! So I decided out of the three different layouts you could choose, three. Not to do the table runner because it looked really long. I really do like the wall hanging. And I didn't realize that these were set differently, because if you look super close, they look like they're backwards or upside down from each other. And the reason for that is this is a table topper. So if you're on one side of the table, you get one view. And if you're on the other side of the table, you get the other view. But I'm going with the wall hanging. And the reason I'm going with the wall hanging is I have a perfect spot in my new sewing room corner right above my sewing ironing table. So that's where it's going to go. Plus, if I ever do decide I want to chuck it on my table, nobody's going to realize that they're all upside down or the wrong way around or whatever they are. They're still going to like it. And so am I. So I have all my clues made up, ready to go. Now, what I have to do, according to my instructions, is make up the blocks. So there are, how many blocks are there? There are tulip blocks, flower baskets, and I think we're making two of each. The pinwheel flower and the gnome. Those are single blocks, but the others are doubles. So they should be pretty easy to put together. So now I have to dig in my envelopes to find all the bits and pieces, because the first ones that I have to put together, which are the tulips, I need to join 1C to 5A and 1D to 5A. So I have to go rooting through my envelopes to find all the, good job I labeled everything. So I will turn you down so you can see the design on my cutting board as we are going. And I hope you enjoy this fun little part. And I hope I get it all in. We just had one of the ridiculous alerts on our telephones that normally tells you, not that they're ridiculous, but they scare the life out of me every time they happen. Normally it's because there's a child being abducted or something like that. Today it's to tell us about a severe weather front coming in, some severe thunderstorm or another. I nearly jumped out my jay when it went off. So I have to get this done because you never know, we could lose power if it's that bad. I hope not. Okay, see you in a bit. Okay, so I have my pieces, my 1C and my 5A. So now I have to lay them in such a way they're going to look like a tulip, which right now they don't. So, look at that. There's my tulip. Now I get it. So what I have to do is fold these over and sew them together. And you know me, and making sure I line up my seams first. I need to make sure I do that. The flower just flickered. Scary. I don't like thunderstorms. I've never liked them. And my backyard's full of trees. I'm always scared it's gonna bring a tree down. So I will stitch these all together, making sure that they all are meeting, and pin them. That one has to go that way because that one is going that way. I'm talking to myself. And pin that one there. So they are pinned, and I will then just sew straight down here with my quarter inch foot. and my 1.6 stitch length and my white thread. And I'll do that for the other one and be right back. All right, those are done. So we'll just press our seams. And press them open. Oh, the lights keep going low. I don't know if you can see it from your end, but there we go. Anyway, that's puckered a bit there. Can you see that? Okay. So I'm just gonna pull that out a bit. There we go. Oh, I think I hear the thunder. So there's one tulip. Well, it still doesn't look that great there. I might have to unpick that. Jack, where are you, Jack? Ah, I see, that's what happened. Sometimes when you get to where there's a bunch of seams, it jumps, and I think that's what happened there. I think it jumped. So I will just unpick the little bit there. Let's see. And right there where it met. Like that. And again, even though you have to unpick sometimes, and we all do, it's a teeny tiny bit of a seam. So I'll just pop that back underneath and very quickly sew that back again. There, now we'll give it another press and see what that looks like. Is that any better? Yeah. Still has a little crease there, but nothing like it was before. These are so much fun to do. Because literally when you're making these little mystery quilts, because you're doing, you know, each block, every other day, or if you do the big one once a month, you forget what all the blocks look like. You forget what you've made. And then when you go to put it together, you're like, how is this ever going to make a shape? How is this ever going to be something? And then suddenly it is. And suddenly it's a tulip. All right, so next, I got a little loose thread there. Where's my scissors? The next part is, so we've done this bit. We now have to add block A, which is these two little pieces that came in our finishing kit. So they will get added. Now it says you can choose your own adventure. You have to put one on either one end and the other end, depending on what your final quilt will look like. So let me look at mine. This is gonna be mine. So I think I'm needing my block to go there at the top. Cause that's what I'm doing. Let's just see. Yes, they both go at the top. So, oh, this is an easy part. Fold this over. Pin and sew. Again, with the white, I have to be super careful because it's hard to tell the right and the wrong side. So I will now sew along there. And there are the tulip blocks done. So cute. Okay, next we are going to be working on the flower baskets. All right, let's see what we have to do for that. Just going to put these on the design wall, so when I come to lay them out later, I know where they're going. Okay, so I now need to make two flower baskets. The instructions below show you how to make both at the same time. You have a finishing strip at the top or the bottom, depending on your, I believe mine's at the top, I think. Or is it at the bottom? I don't know. Okay, so I need 1A. 1A. There's 1A. And 4A. What did 4A look like? I think it's this. I labeled it 4B, but I believe it's this. So that will go like that. And these will go like that. First of all, and they will be sewn together and pressed that way. Okay. And there is these two pieces. So I'll put them there because I feel like we're going to need them again. Then I need the other part of those fours, which has the lighter at the top, and 3A. And this was the 3A's. And they are literally just gonna go like that, I think. Yes, but these are a little bit creased where they've been in the envelope, so I'm gonna give them a quick press. There. So now we have to be careful once again because I've got seams that are all gonna be joining up, and I have to make sure it's a pale, then a pale, and a dark. So that's right. So fold that over, line up my seams, and then that will be ready to go. There's one already straight down there. And here comes this one. Oh, now this looks wrong. As if you notice there, they're all going the right way. Here, going the wrong way. So which way are they gonna go? Well, just there. I finally got it. How many times did we go around that circle? Square. I know it's a square. Okay, so line those up. and pin them. Gosh, it was so hot here this morning. That's probably why we're getting a storm. I mean, super, really sickly hot. And I have shorts and everything on. And then, of course, next thing you know, we have a thunderstorm and it's black as spades out there now. All right, so those are done. So we'll just give them a quick seam press and just dropped my instructions on the floor. So I don't know which way they're supposed to be going. They're going that way. So does that mean this way? Got my nails done. Did you notice? My son sent me money. My son in Nova Scotia sent me money for Mother's Day. So, okay, wait, no, I always get this mixed up. Okay, so it's going towards this. So this has to be on the top. yeah, so he sent me some money to get my nails done. Haven't been in like 2 years. Oh gosh, it's probably more than that. And come on, get on there. So it was so nice to go and just get them all trimmed and lovelied up. She asked me, did I want the shellac stuff on it? But oh my God, I nearly died when she told me how much it was going to cost. So I said, no thanks, just a regular manicure is fine. Everything is so expensive these days. All right, so now, what are we doing? Oh, now we have to add all some other bits. I need a 4B and a 4A. I don't even know if this is 4A. 4A. Wait now. Oh, gosh, what a nerd. This will go there. And this will go... Oh my gosh, look! It's a basket! Oh, that's so cute! Oh, oh, oh! How fun! I wouldn't have seen that before. So now this goes on there. I'll pick it up and turn it. And of course, I have to match all my bases up. Sometimes I fuss and fiddle with this to get it right, but it's just the way it is. This is so cool to put this together like this. You literally have no idea how it's going to turn out. Or how are you going to get the shape you're going to get? That's what blows my mind. It's like I wouldn't have thought for a minute that's what we were making with these pieces, but we are. So there's one. I will pin the other one, sew it, and be right back to show you. Oh, don't they look sweet? Oh my gosh, little flower baskets. Look at that. I love it. Okay, so now what do we have to do with these two little beauties is we have to add the borders on. So are these the A borders? I think they must be. One is longer than the other, so let's see. Oh, there's two small ones. So if our basket goes that way, which it does, these two will go there. Is there only two of them? And these will go there. Are they all the same size? No. Well, I don't know how that works with this one. Oh, I don't know. Let me see. Do I need that A anywhere else? Do I need A anywhere else? It doesn't look like I do. No, I don't think I do. So we can just trim them then, if that's the case. So I will start with that's the right side. Sewing these two sides together. I shall pin them. And of course, the beauty of this is that there's no seams to match. It's just a straight edge to edge. So I am doing that on both sides, right? Yeah, wait a minute. Choose your adventure. Oh, remember that now. Wait, choose your adventure. For both units, you may attach, you may optionally attach one 2x10 to the bottom, top, or sizes, however it suits your final layout. Addition of the rectangular. Okay, so I've got to look and see what I'm supposed to be doing with these. So, gosh, this is actually a little bit confusing. Where's the other layout piece? When we stick them all together. I think it just goes on the top. Oh, it says to wait until we've got our layouts. Okay, we won't do that part then. Off you pop. Because we don't know how we're gonna lay it out, so we'll pop that back over there. So there's our flower box blocks done. Flower basket block. So I'll stick them up there on the wall. All right. This might just be a bit more complicated than I thought then. So now we're doing the petals. So we've done that one and we've done that one. Don't need that. So now we're going to do the petals. What do we need for the petals? Pinwheel flower. Gather 2B and 5B. Arrange layout into the petal arrangement you enjoy. Okay. 2B. 2B. 2B and 5B. Is this what we need? 2B and 5B? 2B and 5. Yes. So we're gonna go with. How many are we making of this? Oh, we're only making one. That way. That way, see, that's not right. That way, because our big block has to be at that end. That does not look like a flower. Oh, yes, it does. Oh, yes, it does. Look, it's a little flower. So you can do it that way, or you can do light petal left, medium petal right, as shown in the design. Light petal top, medium petal bottom, diagonal petal placement, rotate petals outwards. What does it mean? Does it mean we could do that? It kind of looks nice. Or no, I like it the way I just had it. Like that. I think I like that better. Oh, and it makes a little pinwheel in the middle. Okay, I like it like that. So, I have to sew that to that. That to that. And then that to that. Okay, that looks lovely. I really like that. So now I have to add 3B. 3B. And that will go like that. Oh, that's going to be dicey trying to match that one up. All right, but we'll try it. And if it doesn't match, doesn't matter. I'm the boss of my quilt. This is so much fun. And what I really like about this is that they're giving you an options all the way along. They're letting you decide how you want to set this up. Not only have they given you three different layouts, which is awesome, they have let you decide how you're going to put them. How you to orientate them. Let's just give that a finger press because it was going the wrong way. And then we press this. Sew this and then come back and we're done. So let us just press this. Oh, these are lovely. That one's a bit off, but again, I don't care. Gosh, I'm starving. I had a wrap for my lunch today, but absolutely starving now. I don't even know what time it is. Because my phone's up there. Oh, there's the flower. Ah, I love it. Okay, put it on the design wall. Now, the last one is the gnome. And hands up, who knew that was a gnome? Because I didn't. So, we need 1B. That's that. And again, there's only one of these. 1B. 4C. 4C. Yeah, that's going that way. And 2A, our last piece. Oh, look at that. How fun is that? Okay, so I will be sewing these all together. Press them, and then I'll take you to the design wall while we put it
together. Okay, look at the gnome. Isn't he so cute?
Okay, so now we have to lay this all together according to our directions. With the sashing and that other piece that I don't know where it goes yet. So let's start with, this really is like a jigsaw puzzle. Let me get that out the way there and that out the way. So this one is gonna go that way, like that. Oh, I see where that little piece goes. think it goes there. This, by the way, is a tablecloth that I got at the dollar shop. One of them vinyl ones. And the other side is literally just fluffy stuff. And it sticks perfectly. So I have it pinned to the wall with thumbtacks. So that will go like that. So below it is the gnome. Does he? No, he just goes like that. Well, he's tinier than that. How's that gonna work? Oh wait, he does come over there. Okay, and then these are the big strips. So this one will go there. Like that. This one goes there. Like that. Okay, then we need another strip. There. And a flower. Tulip. Tiptoe through the tulips. Like that. And then another one. And then the flower goes there. And then another white strip that I dropped goes there. And then I need a strip there. Then I need the flower. Okay, so they're offset. Then the strip. And then that. Oh. Okay, so that goes there. And that little piece goes there. And then that one goes there. Cute as that. Obviously I have to sew all the bits and bobs together, but I think that looks kind of cool. Yeah. Well, I'm starving, so I'm gonna go upstairs and get something to eat and come back later tonight and finish this and then do a final reveal for you when it's all sewn together. We did get some binding fabric, but they didn't provide us with backing just because we're not sure how, like, they didn't know if we were going to make the table runner or either of these two different layouts. So they couldn't, it was a mystery to them as much as it was to us how we would finish it. So I like it. Yeah. I might even change it around a bit before I sew it. Okay, see you later. And it's finished. Look at it. Oh my gosh, I absolutely love it. Isn't it nice? I did end up switching these two blocks. I just felt it gave it more of a, I don't know, the better feel for it than the way they were before. Maybe not. But I really like it. And it was a joy to put together. A lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed it. And it was has been a lot of fun to sew it up over the last 3 weeks. So I hope you have enjoyed my Toby Knits special quilty fun with the spring mini mystery kit from Cotton Cuts. I would highly recommend getting another one of these mini kits if they bring them out again. I'm pretty sure they will. They did one for Valentine's. This was the spring one. I feel like they might do a summer one and definitely a Christmas one. Oh, I hope they do a Christmas one because I'm getting that if they do. If you watched last Friday's Quilty Fun, you will see all the new colorways for the Piazza, the next
I can't say the word, for the next mystery quilt, which goes on for 10 months. So each month you get some pieces to sew together. Pre-cut, remember? At the end of the 10 months, ta-da, you get to reveal what your mystery quilt will look like. It's a lot of fun, a lot of fun. You will see what I mean if you look at last week's Fridays. Just gone. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going up for a cup of tea and a sit down. I hope you have enjoyed today's video. And please give me a thumbs up, subscribe if you are not already. And I will be now back to my regular Mondays is knitting, Wednesdays is floss tube, cross stitch, and Fridays is quilty fun. Okay, bye!